From strength to strength, each one appears before God in Zion. The message is titled From Strength to Strength. From strength to strength.
The force on force.
There are so many ways that by which we can break down this topic.
Alors il y a plusieurs manières par lesquelles nous pouvons décortiquer ce sujet.
From strength to strength means so many things.
De force en force signifie plein de choses.
But because of time, we are going to look at just two.
Mais à cause du temps, on va regarder juste à
two ways by which we can break down this topic.
Deux moyens par lesquels on peut décortiquer ce sujet.
From strength to strength.
De force en force.
Number one.
Première chose.
Is that God wants us to make progress in life.
C'est que Dieu veut que nous fassions du progrès dans la vie.
From strength to strength.
De force en force.
God wants us to make progress.
Dieu veut que nous fassions du progrès dans la vie.
He wants us to move from one level to another.
Il veut que nous allons d'un niveau à un autre.
That's why it's from strength to strength.
C'est pour ça que c'est de force.
From one level to another.
D'un niveau à un autre.
Never stagnant.
Jamais stagnant.
In fact, I would like to say that no Christian, no child of God.
En fait, je voudrais dire qu'aucun chrétien, aucun enfant de Dieu.
Is permitted to remain stagnant.
N'est permis de rester stagnant.
No child of God, no Christian is permitted to remain on the same spot forever.
Aucun enfant de Dieu n'est permis de rester au même endroit.
God has made adequate provision.
Dieu a fait les provisions suffisantes.
For every one of us to make progress.
Pour que chacun d'entre nous fasse du progrès.
In all aspects of our lives.
Dans tous les aspects de nous.
For us to make progress.
Pour que nous puissions faire du progrès.
Progress spiritually.
Le progrès spirituel.
Progress maritally.
Le progrès marital.
Progress concerning your career.
Le progrès sur ta carrière.
Progress in every area.
Le progrès dans tous les domaines.
That is the will of God for you and I.
C'est la volonté de Dieu pour vous et moi.
So you need, if that is what God wants for me.
Alors c'est ce que Dieu veut pour moi.
Then you need to ask yourself.
Alors on doit se poser la question.
Am I making progress?
Est-ce que je fais du progrès?
Everybody needs to answer that question.
Chacun doit répondre à cette question.
We are already in the month of June.
Nous sommes déjà dans le mois de juin.
Am I making progress? If that is the case, then there is a problem somewhere.
Si c'est le cas, il y a un problème quelque part.
Because God does not want us to remain stagnant.
Parce que Dieu ne veut pas que nous demeurions stagnants.
Or maybe you have even backslid.
Or peut-être tu as rétrogradé.
Now when you are talking about backsliding,
et qu'on parle de rétrograde,
most times we make this error.
Parfois on fait cette erreur.
Of thinking that it is only those who have abandoned God.
De penser que c'est seulement ceux qui ont abandonné.
Those who have abandoned church.
Ceux qui ont abandonné l'église.
Those who have come back from the Lord.
Ceux qui sont qui ont quitté la.
We assume that they are only.
On suppose que ce sont les seuls qui ont rétrogradé.
Okay, that is very true. Anyone that has abandoned God has gone back into the world has backslid.
C'est vrai que celui qui a abandonné Dieu est rentré dans le monde.
But I'd like to submit to you today.
Et je voudrais vous dire aujourd'hui.
Anyone who is not going forward.
Que quiconque n'avance pas.
Anyone who is stagnant.
Quiconque est stagnant.
Has also backslid.
A aussi rétrogradé.
Because the truth of the matter is backsliding does not happen once.
Parce que la vérité est que la rétrograde a
été dans un temps. It is a process.
C'est un processus.
If you are supposed to be going forward. And you are standing in the same place.
Mais tu restes au même endroit.
Other people will be going past you.
D'autres personnes vont être
traversées. So they will be ahead and you will be at the back.
Ils seront devant et toi tu seras derrière.
That's why I'm saying if you are supposed to be making progress.
C'est comme je dis, si tu dois faire du progrès.
If you are supposed to be going forward.
Si tu dois aller de l'avant.
And you are standing and you are stagnant.
Et tu restes sur place, tu es stagnant.
You are backslid.
Alors tu as rétrogradé.
So you need to ask yourself.
Alors tu dois te poser la question.
Am I making progress?
Est-ce que je fais du progrès?
Or am I backslid?
Ou est-ce que j'ai rétrogradé?
Spécialement when it comes to our relationship with God.
Lorsqu'il est question de notre relation.
As I said earlier, God wants us to make progress.
Alors Dieu veut que nous fassions du progrès.
In every area of our lives.
Dans tous les domaines de notre
but
vie.
Most importantly.
Mais plus important encore.
We need to make progress.
Nous devons faire du progrès.
In our relationship with God.
Notre relation avec
because
Dieu.
Everything begins from there.
Parce que tout commence tout là.
The Bible says seek him first.
Et venez rechercher d'abord.
The kingdom of God.
Le royaume de Dieu.
Every other thing will follow.
Tout autre chose suivra.
So everything begins.
Alors tout commence avec ta relation avec Dieu.
In Proverbs chapter 4, verse 18,
dans Proverbes 4, verset 18,
Proverbs 4, 18,
Proverbes 4,
the Bible says the path of the just,
de chanter du
the path of the just,
de chanter du juste.
Still talking about the righteous,
parlant du juste.
Still talking about the children of
parlant
God,
des enfants de
the
Dieu.
Path of the just,
de chanter du
is like the shining sun,
est comme une lumière
the Bible says it shines more and more.
Et ça, c'est l'aspect sur lequel nous voulons nous focaliser.
In the next 15 or 20 minutes,
dans les prochaines 15 ou 20 minutes.
Is that God wants us to depend less on ourselves?
Alors Dieu veut que nous dépendons moins de nous-mêmes.
And depend more on Him.
Et que nous dépendons plus
from
de lui.
Strength to strength.
De force en force.
Depending less on ourselves.
Et pas moins de nous.
And depending more on God.
Pour dépendre plus de Dieu.
Of course, we all have our strengths.
Oui, nous avons tous nos forces.
And I'm talking about our ability and capacity to get this done.
Alors,
alors
commençons par nos activités journalières.
Our normal day-to-day routine.
Notre routine journalière.
For many people, it's a life of struggle.
Pour plusieurs personnes, c'est une vie de combat.
Including some children of God.
Et puis les enfants de Dieu.
It's a life of struggle.
C'est une vie de combat.
Ask some people.
Demande à certaines personnes.
How are you doing?
Comment est-ce que tu vas?
How is business? How is
comment va les affaires? Comment va le travail?
Their response is the same all the time.
Leur réponse est la même tout le temps.
We are struggling,
oh. Oh, on se bat.
We are struggling.
On se bat.
If that has been your language,
si ça a été ton langage,
so today that language will change.
Today. Les gens pensent après avoir étudié
pour faire un examen. It's not always the case.
Non, ce n'est pas toujours le
so
cas.
I expect every student.
Alors je m'attends à
ce que les gens out of the house, before you go and write that exam.
Avant d'aller écrire votre examen.
Lord, yes, I have done my own part.
Oui, Seigneur, j'ai fait ma
part. But I need you to help me.
Mais j'ai besoin de
I need your strength. I need your wisdom.
J'ai besoin de ta force.
To be able to pass this exam.
Pour réussir cet
examen. You are going to work every day.
Tu vas au travail tous les jours.
Colossians chapter 1,
verse 11.
We need the strength of God to be able to overcome satanic attacks. Colossians chapter 1,
Colossians chapter 1,
verse 11.
Verse 8.
It says, strengthened with all might, according to his glorious power, for all patience and long suffering with joy. Now keep in mind, brothers and sisters, one of the characteristics of a Christian,
c'est la capacité de supporter les choses difficiles.
How did Jesus handle such a situation? When he found himself in such a, how did he handle it?
Alors dans 1 Pierre chapitre 2,
2.
1 Pierre 2.
From verse 21 to 23.
Verset 21 à 23.
For to this you are called, because Christ also suffered for us. Did he suffer?
Yes.
So if you are suffering, is it something you know? Because Christ also suffered for us, leaving us an example that you should follow his steps. Verse 22. Who committed no sin, nor was deceit found in his mouth? Who, when he was reviled, did not revile in return? When he suffered, he did not threaten, but committed himself to him who judges righteously. That is Jesus Christ for you.
Ça, c'est Jésus Christ pour vous.
He didn't commit any sin.
Il n'a pas commis de péché.
They accused him wrongly.
On l'a accusé faussement.
But he didn't, because of that,
mais pas à cause de
ça, remove his robe and start to fight.
Il n'a pas enlevé sa robe et commencé
they
à combattre.
They abused him.
On l'a insulté.
They did all manners of evil things to him.
On lui a fait toutes choses de méchanceté.
He didn't, because of that, say, no, I'm no longer a child of God. I'm no longer the son of God.
Il n'a pas dit à cause de ça, je suis plus
un enfant. I must take revenge.
Je dois me venger.
He didn't do that.
Il n'a pas fait ça.
He didn't do that.
Il n'a pas fait ça.
But he abstained. I know that some people can be very sarcastic, very, they can be like pepper in your eye.
Alors, je sais qu'il y a des gens qui peuvent être très sarcastiques.
Some people can be very terrible.
Il y a des gens qui peuvent être terrible.
But I'm saying, as a child of God,
mais je dis en tant qu'enfant
de Dieu, God expects you to show good example as Jesus.
Je t'attends que tu montres bon exemple comme Jésus a fait.
People may do anything they want to do to you.
Les gens peuvent faire n'importe quoi.
I'm not saying it's easy.
Je dis pas que c'est facile.
I'm not saying it's easy.
Je dis pas que c'est facile.
When people abuse you, for you not to abuse them back.
Quand les gens t'insultent,
I'm not saying it's easy.
Comment ne pas les insulter?
I'm talking about from strength. Strength.
Mais on parle de force en force.
If you depend on God, God can help you to
overcome. Si tu dépends de Dieu, Dieu peut te permettre de vaincre.
I've told you before, even as a pastor.
Alors je vous ai dit même en tant que
pasteur. Somebody abused me far back in
several years ago. Quand quelqu'un m'insultait des années auparavant.
When somebody abused me, I wanted to abuse the person back.
Quand quelqu'un m'insultait, je voulais insulter la personne aussi.
Because of that, I've shared the testimony several times. I was driving on the streets of Lagos. Somebody one moment was doing like this to me.
Un jour je conduisais à Lagos, quelqu'un me faisait comme ça.
I was the one on the right track. He wanted to overtake me. I didn't allow him. He was abusing.
J'étais sur le bon chemin, il voulait me dépasser.
And I was angry. You know, I just lost from work.
Alors j'étais fatigué.
I was already tired.
J'étais fatigué.
And somebody was doing like this to me.
Quelqu'un me faisait comme ça.
I wanted to do like this. Suppose a member of Big Girls is in that bus.
Can
you receive that grace and strength to remain calm
in
the face of temptation and provocation in the mighty name of Jesus? Lastly,
finalement,
we need the strength of God
de la force de Dieu
to succeed in our spiritual
life. Dans nos vies spirituelles.
This is where we started from.
C'est là où on a commencé.
And that is where we are going to end.
Et c'est là où
strength
on a
of God
on a besoin de la force
to
de
succeed
Dieu
in our spiritual
pour
life.
Dans nos vies spirituelles.
Satan does not want any of us to finish this race.
Satan ne veut pas qu'on termine cette course.
Let alone finish it well.
Moi,
it doesn't want us to finish, not to talk of finishing well.
Même pas qu'on finisse bien.
And we will do anything to make sure that it stops us.
Pour qu'il puisse nous stopper.
And I'm saying on our own strength.
Et je dis pas notre propre force.
We are no match for the devil.
On ne peut pas payer le diable.
The Bible tells us in Ephesians chapter 6.
Ephesians 6.
Verse 12.
Verset 12.
Ephesians 6, 12.
Ephesians 6.
It says we are wrestling not against flesh and blood.
Nous ne combattons pas contre la chair et le sang.
Against principalities and powers.
Mais contre les principautés.
Against all kinds of wicked forces.
Contre toute forme de méchanceté.
But in verse 13.
Au verset 13.
It says we should put on the whole armor of God.
Nous devons mettre toute l'armure de Christ.
That's talking about the strength of God.
Parlons de la force.
Put on the whole armor.
Verset 13.
Philippiens 4:13.
faut strengthen.
Qui me fortifie.
So we need to go from strength to strength.
On doit aller de force en force.
From our own strength to the strength of God.
De notre force à la force de Dieu.
And I see a very good example.
Et je vois un bon exemple.
In Revelation chapter 3.
Dans l'Apocalypse.
I'll just show you that and then we'll close.
Je vous montre là et on va.
Revelation chapter 3.
Apocalypse 3.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let me read verse 7.
Que je lise le verset 7.
Revelation chapter 3.
Apocalypse 3.
And verse 7. And the angel of the church in Philadelphia, and to the angel of the church in Philadelphia write, these things says he who is holy, he who is true, he who has the key of David, he who opens and no one shuts, and shut. Am I reading the Revelation chapter 3, verse 7? Alright. Now look at verse 8.
Verse 8.
I know your works. See, I have set before you an open door, and no one can shut it. For you have a little strength. That's where I'm going first. So this message was written to a church. The church in Philadelphia. And I've talked in this place before. That all the seven churches that were talked about in the book of Revelation, they represent seven types of people that are found in the church. So this particular church, the church in Philadelphia, particular set of people, Christians.
Ça parle de chrétiens particuliers.
God said concerning that church,
Dieu a dit concernant cette église,
that church had little strength.
Cette église a peu de force.
Very little strength.
Peu de force.
But let's read on.
Continue à lire.
If you have little strength, I've kept my word and I've not denied my name. So that church had little strength.
Alors cette église avait peu de puissance.
But that did not make that church to deny God.
Mais ils n'ont pas renié Dieu.
Just as we have said earlier. Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Yeah.